morning, my dear students. This is your chemistry sir again. Today we are continuing the some basic concepts of chemistry. So in the some basic concepts of chemistry. So in the last classes we have discussed the five laws, law of combinations. So in that, after five law, we have discussed about the Dalton's atomic theory. The Dalton's atomic theory is important for 3 months, and continuation of that one means soon after that molecular mass. So this is the 1 mass question. So they will ask you, what is average atomic mass? Or commonly they will tell you to calculate or solve the average atomic mass of carbon atom, or generally carbon. So what is average atomic mass? So average atomic mass is nothing but, here we are going to calculate the mass of the atom with respect to its isotopes. Isotope is nothing but what? So see here, in the high school you are familiar about the hydrogen. So hydrogen exists, isotopes of the hydrogen. Hydrogen is, if it is having the atomic mass 1, then it is null as a proton. If it is having 2, deuterium and tritium. Protium, deuterium and tritium. So mass of the hydrogen, if it is 1, it is a proton. 2, deuterium. 3, tritium. So similarly, carbon exists in the three forms. So existence of the carbon having the same atomic number but different atomic mass is called as isotope. So isotopes are, here carbon, each of the carbon having atomic number same but mass is different. So each of the carbon having 6 only, but I am not mentioned here because atomic number same. The mass of the carbon is different. Here carbon, if it is having atomic mass 12, it is called as C12. It is nothing or the C13. C14 is nothing but it is having the mass 14. So these three are the isotopes of carbon. So isotopes of carbon, they are having the relative abundance. Abundance is nothing but availability or existence in the earth. So in the earth, these are available. The percentage of available, that is called as abundance. Relative abundance means comparing to 12, 13, 14 of this carbon, how much it is available in out of 100%, how much of C12 is present, means it is present 98.892, is in the form of percentage. Overall in 100%, 98.8% is of carbon 12 is available in the earth. Similarly, 1.108% is of carbon 13, and 2 × 10⁻¹⁰% is of carbon 14. So it means moreover we are getting the carbon 12 isotope as greater in the earth. The next one is C13, 10⁻¹⁰, is very less, negligible, 0.000 up to after 10 zero, the 2. So it is very much negligible. So here carbon 12 is 13, 14 and having the this much of availability in the earth. Whereas the carbon 12 is having the atomic mass unit, means U, atomic mass unit of carbon 12 is 12, this mass of the carbon 12 is 12, and mass of the carbon 13 is 13.00335. Similarly, the mass of the carbon 14 is 14.00314, means we are not considering this whole number, it is having some fraction. Even though we are writing that fractions, why? Because to calculate the average atomic mass, these are important. I hope you can able to understand what is this chart explains. It explains about the isotope and it is related to abundance, availability in the earth comparing to its own. And this is the atomic mass of each of the carbon. And using these isotopes, particularly the average atomic mass of carbon, it is. So how we have to calculate the average atomic mass? Look here. To calculate the atomic mass of the carbon, first we have to do the multiplication of 98.89, it is in the percentage. Whereas when considering the availability, not the percentage, means we have to divide this term by 100. Therefore, we will get 0.98, means we are calculating the average atomic mass of carbon is nothing but, can you see here? This is, I multiply 0.98892. This is the relative abundance. This is in the form of percentage, it is not in the form of percentage. That is the difference. If I am writing 98.8, which is percentage,
this much of other, it's not in the form of percentage person. So here carbon colleagues having the abundance in the is 0.98892 and it is having the mass, atomic mass is 12. It is 12. U is nothing but atomic mass in it, plus another carbon C30 is having the abundance 1.1, it is percentage. If you don't want percentage, means we have to divide this term by 100. Therefore, this point should appear to be simple. It is 0 point. If it is 0, means the point should be before the 0. 0.01108. And the atomic mass of carbon 13 is into, we have to multiply this one, 13.00335 atomic mass in unified, others unified, plus the next one is 2 × 10⁻¹⁰. Minus 10 is in the form of percentage. If you don't want percentage, means we have to divide that by 100. 100 is nothing but if it moves to the 100 is 10⁻². 10⁻². If it is moves above, then it becomes 10⁻². Minus 2 and minus 10, it becomes 2 × 10⁻¹⁰. 2 × 10⁻¹⁰. Why? Because here 10⁻²⁻¹⁰. 10⁻²⁻¹⁰. It is in the form of percentage. If we don't want percentage, means we have to divide that by 100. At that time it becomes minus 10 becomes minus 12. By adding minus 2 becomes minus 12. Into, we have to multiply the atomic mass of carbon 14. What is the mass of carbon 14 here? It is 2 here. 14.00317 atomic mass is 14.00317.
So can you see here
I have multiplying these two, the multiplying these two plus multiplying these two plus multiplying these two, but here I have written the relative abundance in the form of percentage, but I have not taken here the percentage, means I have divided the percentage divided by 100, so that I am not getting the percentage, I am getting only the relative abundance. Relative abundance into its own atomic mass. Atomic mass. So multiplying these two and adding, we are going to get the value. The value itself is the average atomic mass. Therefore, the average atomic mass of the carbon is, we just multiply these two, plus multiply these two, and plus multiply these two. So you are going to get the answer 12. Here the average atomic mass of carbon is 12.011 U. U is nothing but unified. Atomic mass unit can be expressed in the form of unified. Small letter U indicates the unified. I hope can you able to understand. The question will arise in such a way that calculate the average atomic mass of carbon. So that you should be capable to write this one. Isotope, relative abundance, atomic mass. Can you able to visible this one? Try to understand when seeing the video. Write the notes also. The next concept is molecular mass. It will be asked for commonly 2 marks. They will tell you calculate the molecular mass of water, calculate the molecular mass of methane, glucose, carbon dioxide, like that they will ask you. So I hope in the bridge course you are familiar about the molecular mass, even in the high school also. So molecular mass is nothing but you need to calculate the mass of molecule which they have given. For example, in the left I have written the mass of some atoms, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. These are the mass of the atoms. So they will tell you to calculate the molecular mass of CH4 is nothing but methane. So here, if they ask you just to write this one, in the methane, carbon, number of carbon atoms are 1. The mass of the carbon atom is 12. Therefore, 1 × 12 is equal to 12 unit, means unified. So number of hydrogens here is, how many hydrogens are totally? 4 hydrogens are there. Therefore, number of hydrogens are 4 into each of the mass of hydrogen is 1, therefore 4 into 1 is equal to 4u. So it's containing only carbon and hydrogen, therefore just add this one, 12 plus 4 is 16u. So this is the molecular mass of methane. Similarly, molecular mass of water, H2O. So in H2O, water, the hydrogen and oxygen, number of hydrogens are 2. Each of the hydrogens have the mass 1. 2 into 1, 2. And oxygen, total number of oxygen in the water molecule is 1. Therefore, each of the oxygen 1, and having the mass of 1 oxygen is 16. 16 into 1, 16 u, unified. So 16 plus 2 is 18. 18 atomic mass unit. Here, can you guess this one? Molecular mass is nothing but it is simply a mass of the molecule whichever they have given. If they may give you the carbon dioxide or methane, glucose, benzene, whichever they may give, so based on you should be capable to write the molecular masses. So that these are the some assignments or thing that it's a homework. So whichever I am giving as a homework, you can write this in the notes also and also write that as an assignment in the assignment book. Okay. So calculate the molecular mass of C6H2O4. So that's glucose. So this is first one. And second one, calculate the molecular mass of carbon dioxide. Calculate the molecular mass of benzene. Benzene is having the formula C6H6. Calculate the molecular mass of so if benzene containing the NH2 is called as aniline. So these are the molecular mass and it is 4. We have to calculate. This is about the molecular masses. I would like to make it clear, the molecular mass and formula of mass both are almost similar. There is no difference. Why? Because in the molecular mass we are saying the compound as a molecule. In the formula mass is nothing but whichever we are saying, benzene is nothing but we are saying the name, and based on that name we should be capable to write the formula. If we say sodium chloride, it's nothing but we are saying the name, but you have to write the formula proper. So sodium chloride is nothing but NaCl, sodium chloride. Here, this is the formula. To this formula you have to calculate the mass. Sodium chloride. It is sodium chloride as this sodium containing 1 and chlorine is 1. Each of the sodium is having the mass 23, therefore 23 equivalent is 23 atomic mass unit. Each of the chlorine is having the mass 35.5. So 35 same as it is equivalent means 35.5 atomic mass unit. Therefore 23.0 it is, therefore 0.5 as it is 5 plus 3. 8, 3 plus 2, 5, 58.5 atomic mass unit. It will be the molecular mass of sodium chloride means it is also same. The formula mass of sodium chloride means it is also same. Means we are calculating the mass on the basis of formula it is, whereas in the previous it is also based on the formula, but we are saying that as molecule. There is no difference between the molecular mass and formula mass. Got it? So next one is mole concept and molar masses. So this is very simple and interesting concept. Mole concept is nothing but in the last which course also we have studied it. Mole is nothing but it is simply a 1 mole of the compound. 1 mole, NaCl, it's only 1 NaCl, therefore it's called as 1 mole. 2 NaCl, then we are calling that as 2 Na, that 2 indicates that 2 mole. If the simple molecular mass is there, well, then we are calling that as a 1 mole without any numerical or without any coefficient values we are writing. If we are writing only C6H6, benzene, single only one benzene is there, it means 1 mole.
2 C6 and 6 if we are writing, then we are calling it as 2 mole.
Simple concept is H2 plus O reduce water. H2 we are not considering, we are considering the coefficient. If here nothing is there, if I have written 2 H2, it is 2 water. So number of moles of hydrogen it is 2. So 2 mole reacts with 2 mole of hydrogen, reacts with 1 mole of the oxygen to give 2 mole of the water molecule. Our understanding mole concept is nothing but we are saying the number of molecules. How many molecules are there? That the molecule itself is called as mole. 2 mole of the hydrogen reacts with 1 mole of the oxygen to give 2 mole of the water. So this is about the mole. I hope this is clear for you what is mole. So mole concept and molar mass. I will come to know what is molar mass. So let's see what is this mole concept explains. Means 1 mole of any of the component. 1 mole of any of the component. It may be a sodium chloride, it may be a benzene, or it may be any of the component. Hydrogen, single hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, methane, glucose, anything. If 1 mole of the one mole of any of the component, it is containing how many atoms? How many atoms are there? Means how many particles are there? How many small size of the atoms or particles are present? If I say hydrogen, it is nothing is written there. If nothing is there, means 1 mole of hydrogen. If 1 mole of hydrogen, how simply I write NaCl. NaCl, it is nothing is there, means 1 will be there. Means 1 mole of the NaCl. How many atoms are there? If NaCl is nothing but its atom mass 58.5. Just now we have calculated in the formula mass. And similarly, the mass of methane is nothing but the, it is 12, 13, 14, 16 atomic mass. So 1 mole of methane is having 16 atomic mass. 1 mole of sodium chloride is having 58.5. So in this each of the sodium chloride, methane or hydrogen, these three are having only 1 mole. Means hydrogen it is also 1 because 1 mole. Sodium chloride it is also containing 1. Methane it is also 1. So any of the compound, if it is containing 1 mole, we are not saying based on the masses. We are saying if the compound is 1 mole, then it is having the exactly same number of the particles present in the carbon 12. Means carbon we are considering as a standard one. Therefore, based on 1. So 12 gram of carbon 12. Carbon 12 mass is 12 itself. So how many atoms are present in carbon 12 of the atom? So carbon 12 is one of the atom. If carbon 12 is containing some amount of the atom, means what? If carbon is present, it's having the mass 12 means. It doesn't mean that it's not having only single carbon. The atoms of the carbons are more. Together, a single carbon we are having, we are saying that it's having 12 gram. Similarly, if we are saying the mass of single hydrogen is 1, here it is the number of hydrogens are 2. Therefore, it is 2 atomic mass unit. It means that it is not having only 2 hydrogens. It is having sub atoms are there. Means we are calling that as particles or number of atoms per mole. So, how much atoms are there in 1 mole? Or if carbon 12 is 12 gram, the mass of the carbon is 12 unit atomic mass unit. If 12 atomic mass unit, it means no doubt it is having 1 carbon. Means 1 mole of the carbon is containing some amount of the atom, some amount of the atoms. So if we take a single water drop, H2O, H2O is nothing but it is having 18 atomic mass unit. 18 atomic mass unit, it doesn't mean that a single H2O, yes, exactly it is a single H2O. It not means that a single drop of H2O, a fraction drop of H2O is containing 1 mole of H2O. Means 1 mole of H2O is containing some atoms in that, some atoms. No doubt it is hydrogen and oxygen only. The total number of that H2O atoms are how much, that will be explained on the basis of mole concept. So what is that mole? So 1 mole is nothing but, 1 mole is nothing but, it is the number of atoms present, exactly as much as atoms present in carbon 12. As much as atoms present in carbon 12 means how many atoms are present in carbon 12, means carbon is having the mass 12. How many atoms are present in carbon 12? that much of atoms itself is called as one whole, because we are considered as carbon 12 as a standard atom. So based on the carbon, we are comparing the mass of other compound, and also we are defining the mole. So one mole is nothing but it is the quantity or the number of atoms present. Exactly how much the atoms are present in carbon 12. So carbon 12 is nothing but it is 12 gram of carbon, means per mole, means one mole of carbon is nothing but one carbon is having 12 gram. So each of the carbon, the mass of the carbon can be determined by mass spectrum. Mass spectrum is nothing but it is one of the graph. It is a machine. You are going to use that in PG. If you are doing MSc in chemistry, you are going to use that. Means you can have that application uses. So using the mass spectrum, it is possible to calculate the mass of carbon, oxygen, any of the single non-visible gaseous compounds. Mass can be calculated by some of the instruments. That is, among those, there are many number of instruments are there. Among those, one is mass spectrum. So using that mass spectrum, it is possible to calculate the mass of the carbon. So according to that, the mass of the carbon is 1.992648 × 10⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻²⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻⁻ zeros, we are going to get the mass of carbon, which is very much negligible. So what we are doing is, we are dividing the 12 gram of carbon, means each of the carbon is having 12 gram. So 12 gram of per mole means carbon which is having the mass 12 gram. We are dividing the mass which we calculated by the mass spectrum instrument. Mass spectrum instrument means this is the manually calculated molecular mass of carbon 12. This is experimentally calculated molecular mass of carbon 12, but in the form of gram, means per carbon 12 atoms is having this much of gram. Similarly, this is per means single carbon 12 is having 12 gram per mole. This is manually. So we are dividing this one. Why? Because to calculate the number of atoms per carbon. So by dividing this one, we are going to get the value 6.022137 newton plus 23. This is plus 23 atoms per mole. This number is itself called as Avogadro constant. Avogadro constant. We are representing that value by the symbolic representation capital N. Capital A, but it is in the subscript, means N A. This is called as Avogadro number. So Avogadro number or Avogadro constant is nothing but this value. How we are going to get this value? Means we are dividing the 12 gram of carbon by the mass calculated by mass spectrum. Mass of the carbon calculated by the mass spectrum. By dividing this one, we are going to get how many atoms are present in a carbon 12 atom. So each of the carbon 12, a single carbon 12 atom is having the 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms. This much of atoms are present in one mole. A single carbon is having this much of atom, means 6 into, in front of the 6 you have to write 23 zeros. 23 zeros, just to imagine, in the front of 0 means it is either plus 4 plus 23. In front of the 6 you have to write total 23 zeros. You have to write the 23, how much it is, very much huge quantity. Means a single carbon is having that much of the atoms, that much of the atom. So how many atoms are present in one mole? Means it is present in 6.022137 × 10⁻²³. This much of atoms present in each or any of the molecules, any of the molecule. Therefore, this number itself is called as Avogadro constant or Avogadro number. This is represented by symbolically NA. Therefore, NA is nothing but 6.022. Just you can write only this much: 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms per mole. So I would like to clear you the picture is, what is mole concept? One mole is nothing but it is containing exactly the number of atoms present in carbon 12 molecule. So each of the carbon 12 molecules is containing 6.02 × 10⁻³ atoms in a single. Therefore, in any of the mole, H2, one mole of hydrogen or one mole of sodium chloride or one mole of the methane, whichever compound you take, one mole of that molecule, that compound, that atom is containing exactly this much of atoms, this much of atoms. So this value itself is called as, in a one mole of any of the molecule, it's containing exactly the number of atoms equal to Avogadro constant, equal to Avogadro constant. You should remember this value. Avogadro constant is 6.022 × 10⁻³. This value is called as Avogadro number or Avogadro constant. So this is represented by the symbol Na. I hope this is clear. If you will be asked for commonly, it's not even asked in the previous, but you should remember more concept is nothing but how we are calculating the Avogadro number. If they ask you explain the mole concept or explain the molecular mass of carbon 12 containing atoms, means we have to begin from here and we have to end upwards. So this will be asked for 2 marks. So this is about the mole concept. So this is about mole concept. So mole concept is going to explain the number of atoms present in one mole. So here the continuity of this mole concept itself is a molar mass. So what is molar mass? Molar mass is nothing but it is a mass of the compound of exactly one mole. One mole is nothing but what? H2O. How many H2O? How many water I am taking? I am taking only one mole of the water molecule. How many? What is the mass of one mole of the water? It is 18 atomic mass unit. So we are taking not 2H2O, not 3H2O, not 4H2O. Exactly one mole of any of the compound. One mole of any of the molecular mass itself is called as molar mass. What is the molar mass of ammonia? Ammonia is having the formula NH3. You have to take only one NH3. One NH3 is itself called as the mass of one NH3 itself is called as molar mass. What is the molar mass of water? Molar mass of water is nothing but it is the mass of the one H2O, means a single water molecule. What is the molar mass of carbon dioxide? Carbon dioxide is nothing but CO2. I am taking only one carbon dioxide. If I have taken 2, means it is 2 mole. 2 mole is nothing but we are not considering the molar mass. Molar mass is nothing but mass of the molecule which is having exactly 1 mole. 1 mole of any of the compounds mass itself is called as molar mass. Are you getting this one? So molecular mass, molar mass, almost it is same. Why? Because in the molar mass we are saying the mass of the compound should be 1 mole. 1 mole. That's all. It's called as molar mass is nothing but mass of that compound which is having exactly 1. I hope it is clear. So they will ask you, calculate the molar mass of carbon dioxide, calculate the molar mass of water, calculate the molar mass of ammonia. So based on that, you should be capable to calculate the molar mass. These are same as it is in the molecular mass. So in NH3, ammonia is, nitrogen is 1, hydrogen is 3. Each of the nitrogen is having the mass 14. 14 ones are 14 atomic mass. Hydrogen is 1, therefore 3. Total molecular mass of nitrogen is 14 plus 3. It is 70 atomic mass. So this is the molar mass of ammonia. I hope this is clear. If still you are having any doubts, feel free to ask. You just text me. I will do another video and I will send you whichever you are having doubts. Okay. The last one in the today's class is percentage composition. Calculate the percentage composition of any one atom they will give in the molecular formula. So look here. Mass percentage of an element. Mass percentage of element is nothing but if they will give you, calculate the mass percentage of hydrogen in the water molecule. So in the water molecule means how you have to calculate mass percentage of an element. Which element if they give you to, they will, if they ask you to calculate the mass percentage of hydrogen in the water molecule, means we are calculating the mass percentage of hydrogen in water. So how we have to calculate means we have to write mass of that element in the compound. Mass of that element in the compound means in water molecules. How many hydrogens are there? 2 hydrogen. So mass of that 2 hydrogen is nothing but how much it is? 2 atomic mass unit. Means each of the hydrogen is having 1. Therefore total hydrogens are 2. So mass of that element in the compound, in the water molecules, the mass of total mass of the hydrogen is 2 divided by molar mass of the compound. Molar mass of the compound means mass of the water molecule. So mass of the water molecule is 18 because oxygen is having the mass 16. 16 plus 2 hydrogen, it is 18 U atomic mass unit. So are you getting this one? Mass percentage of an element is nothing but if you want to calculate the mass of the hydrogen in that compound means first we have to write the mass of that element in that compound. Total mass of the hydrogen is 1, but in the water molecules the total mass of the hydrogen in that compound is 2 atomic mass unit. So divided by molar mass of the compound means 1 molar mass of the water molecule is 18 into 100, because we need to calculate the percentage mass percentage. That's why you have to do that into 100. Therefore here it is 2 into 2, 2 9 are 18, 9 into 9, remaining is 1. So 10 again 9 into 9, again 1 remains, 0.0 again 1. Therefore remaining is 1 into 11.1 percentage, means out of 100%, 11.11% of hydrogen is present in the water molecule. Similarly, if we want to calculate the mass percentage of oxygen in the same hydrogen molecule, calculate the mass percentage of oxygen in water means, calculate the mass percentage of oxygen in the water means mass percentage of which element? Oxygen. That is mass of that element in the compound. So in water molecules the number of oxygen is 1, means each of the oxygen is having the mass 16. Therefore 16 unit divided by molar mass of that compound means mass of the water is 18 into 100. Therefore the calculation part, this is mass of the oxygen in that compound, this is molar mass of the water into 100. 2 8s are 16, 2 9s are 9, 1s are 9, 11.1, 9 is 18, and multiplying this one we are going to get 88.88%. So this is the mass percentage of oxygen in the water molecule. Mass percentage of oxygen in the water molecule. So this is very simple concept. I hope this is clear for you. What is the mass percentage of the compound? Similarly, if they will ask you calculate the mass percentage of C2H5OH, this is called as ethanol. Total number of carbons are 2. Ethane. OH is a functional group of alcohol. Ethanol. In the ethanol, calculate the mass percentage of carbon. Calculate the mass percentage of hydrogen. If they ask you to calculate the mass percentage of hydrogen, means you have to take the total head of oxygen. Oxygen here is 5, here it is 1. Means total hydrogens are 6. You have to write the mass of the liquid means 6 divided by molar mass. You have to calculate the mass of total is compound into 100. Are you getting this one? First one is calculate the mass percentage of carbon, mass percentage of hydrogen. Third one is calculate the mass percentage of oxygen. So this is the homework, and take it as an assignment. You have to calculate the mass percentage of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen individually in this molecule. So we will meet in the tomorrow classes. If you are having any doubts, you can ask me.